Something you spoke about there as well was the duration of your workouts really reduced down. That's something that I did as well. And we'll kind of go into how you put together your schedule when you went through that lockdown period, if you had a schedule. But, you know, I started the podcast during that lockdown period. I was studying my anatomy and physiology. I was putting together content for YouTube. Like, my people were like, dude, how was your, you know, how have you been affected by lockdown? And I was like, I haven't, you know, like the only thing is I don't have to leave my house to go to work. Yeah. I was still getting up at 6 o'clock every morning, and I would still go out and do my morning routine on my balcony and like watch the sunrise, do my meditation, have my coffee, do some reading. And then I'd be in like doing some study, and then I'd start recording podcast content, blah, 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 blah. Like, and then I'd do like a 20-minute block in the morning where I'd go and get some mobility work in, because I just returned from Australia. I'd been back in Thailand for about 10 days before everything locked down, and I did my yoga course, and I was like, all right, I'm going to use this time to really, you know, when I was in the gym, yeah, I'd do some mobility before every training session, but it was just enough to improve my movement quality for that training session. But then once we went into lockdown, I was like, all right, I'm going to make this a priority. I'm going to really focus on the mobility stuff. I'm going to reinforce all of this information that I've just learned on this yoga course. And I'm going to do some mobility slash yoga every morning for 20 minutes. You know, so I'd do that, and then I'd get back into, and then I'd have some food, and then I'd go back into my work, creating content, study, whatever it might be. And then I'd go and do, you know, a 20-minute block of strength-based work around, you know, early mid afternoon, and then if I felt like it, I'd do another 20-minute block of some conditioning, some aerobic conditioning or some anaerobic conditioning in the afternoon. So I was breaking up that 1 hour of training time over 3 20-minute blocks. But what I found was, you know, some days I'd get into a flow state and I would like record 3 podcast episodes, for example, one day. So if I did my mobility work in the morning and then I got into a flow state and I was just like, create content, I'm gonna ride this wave, man. I'm fucking, my creative juices are flowing. I'm gonna continue on this wave. Then I didn't do my strength work and I didn't do my conditioning work. Then I didn't feel bad about myself because I'd done my number one priority.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, love that. I mean, very similar to that, actually. I've got a couple of clients that are, they're pilots. So currently in the air industry, the aviation industry, it's obviously very difficult crossing borders, and the pilots are super restricted to their movement. So they're pretty much in what they call a closed loop. So they'll land in a country, and obviously they're not allowed out into the wider world. So they're literally room to room, and they spend a lot of time in isolation, a lot of time in quarantine. So I've done exactly the same thing. Rather than giving them one session to do in the day, I've actually given them 3. So you can break up 20 to 30 minute blocks to, you know, a little bit of mobility in the morning, first thing when you wake up, maybe after lunch or before lunch, depending on how you're feeling, a little bit of strength work and a little bit of conditioning at the end. So it's probably an hour to an hour and a half of training, but rather hitting up that in one block and then saying, right, what am I going to do for the rest of the day? It's setting those challenges to keep them occupied, right? Because it's a big thing. Number one, looking after your physical health in that situation, but number two, your mental health as well. So having things to focus on and things to work on. So, okay, you know, now I'm in this room for 14 days. It's giving me time to work on my mobility, work on movement. You know, like you just said, to improve. Maybe it's like most of my mobility set, kind of routines that I give my clients as well. There's a lot of yoga stuff involved in that. So again, just trying to find positives in the negatives, and trying to think outside the box in terms of how we're going to break things down and deliver the program.